In this video, we are going to see about dermoepidermal junction, otherwise called as basement membrane zone. So this dermoepidermal junction is a specialized attachment between the epidermis and the papillary dermis. So the cells present in dermoepidermal junction include keratinocytes, melanocytes and Merkel cells. So this basement membrane zone, it is not visible by normal hematoxylin and eosin staining. So for this unit, stains like PAS, where it is visible as thin magenta colored linear band beneath the basal keratinocytes. So the functions of dermoepidermal junction includes cell migration, epidermal-dermal interaction and cell stromal coherence. So the structure, as I said, it is not visible by normal H&E stain. In PAS stain, it is visible because of the presence of mucopolysaccharides and it is about 0.5 to 1 mm in thickness and appears as a homogeneous band. So in electron microscopy, from epidermis to dermis, you can see four structures. First one is the electron dense hemidesmosomes, and then the electron lucent lamina lucida, which is about 30 nanometer in diameter, and the electron dense lamina densa, which is otherwise called as basal lamina, around 40 nanometer in diameter, and then the lamina fibroreticularis, which is visible in silver stain. So this is the basal keratinocyte with keratin filaments, and the keratin proteins present here are keratin 5 and 14. So here you can see this is the basal keratinocyte and this is the hemidesmosome. So this hemidesmosome, it actually has two parts. One is the inner part and outer part. So what we are seeing here is the inner part of the hemidesmosome, which is attached to the cytoplasm of the basal keratinocyte and is linked to these keratin filaments, mainly keratin 5 and keratin 14. So this hemidesmosome inner part, it contains the proteins like one is plectin, another one is bullous pemphigoid 230 kilodalton antigen. It is otherwise called as bullous pemphigoid antigen 1. So both are high molecular weight proteins. And then below that you have the lamina lucida. So this lamina lucida is a part between the plasma membrane and the lamina densa. So this lamina lucida, it contains proteins like alpha 6 beta 4 integrin, BP 180, bullous pemphigoid 180 kilodalton antigen, otherwise called as bullous pemphigoid antigen 2, and then laminin, a part of laminin 5, ladinin, and then uncin. So what is the importance of this uncin? So mutation in this uncin protein can lead to recessive epidermolysis bullosa, that is recessive junctional epidermolysis bullosa. So below the lamina lucida, we have this lamina densa. So this lamina densa is the part between the lamina lucida and the lamina fibroreticularis. Here you have anchoring fibrils. So these are the anchoring fibrils. And also the main type of collagen in lamina densa is collagen 4. So this lamina densa also contains a part of laminin 5. So below that you have the sublamina densa and the lamina fibroreticularis. Lamina fibroreticularis mainly contains these anchoring fibrils. And here the main type of collagen is type 7 collagen. So if you see here, autoantibodies against desmoglein 1 can lead to pemphigus foliaceus. So this is the architectural of desmosome, this one. Here you have these desmosomal cadherin proteins, that is, this is desmoglein, this is desmocholin, this is placoglobin, desmoplakin and placophyllin. So if you see, autoantibodies against desmoglein 1 can lead to pemphigus foliaceus, erythematosus, endemic pemphigus, bullous impetigo and staphylococcal scaldelsin syndrome. Against desmoglein 3 can lead to pemphigus vulgaris and vegetans. Desmocholin 1 can lead to IgA pemphigus. So against this BP230 antigen, you can have bullous pemphigoid and its variants. Even BP180 can cause generalized epidermolysis bullosa and bullous pemphigoid, along with linear IgA disease and cicatricial pemphigoid. So this ladinin present in lamina lucida, at autoantibodies against ladinin can cause linear IgA disease. So this anchoring fibrils containing collagen 7, that is in the lamina fibroreticularis, Autoantibodies against this protein can cause epidermolysis bullosa, dystrophica, acquisita, cicatricial pemphigoid, and bullous lupus erythematosus. So autoantibodies against collagen 4, which is present in the lamina densa, can lead to Alport syndrome and Goodpasture syndrome. Against the keratin cytoskeleton, it can lead to epidermolysis bullosa simplex. And this laminin 5, which is present in both lamina lucida and lamina densa, it can lead to junctional epidermolysis bullosa and cicatricial pemphigoid. So this unseen, I mentioned already, autoantibodies against this, mutation in this protein unseen can lead to junctional recessive epidermolysis bullosa. So coming to hemidesmosomes, as I said already, it has an inner part and outer part. Inner part is the intracytoplasmic part, and it has the attached to tonofilaments keratin 5 and 14, as I mentioned already. Next, the outer part is associated with the plasma membrane. So this hemidesmosome contains anchoring proteins, which we saw already, that is the bullous pemphigoid antigen 1 or 230 kilodalton antigen and the plectin. So these are present in the cytoplasm. And then the transmembrane proteins, that is the integrin alpha 6 beta 4 and the bullous pemphigoid antigen 2. And the additional components involved are P200, IFAB300 and tetraspanin CD151. So if you see, the proteins that is present on the inner part are bullous pemphigoid antigen 1 and plectin, and those in the outer part are this P200 and IFAB300, and the transmembrane proteins are bullous pemphigoid antigen 2, integrin alpha 6 beta 4 and CD151. So there are two types of hemidesmosomes, type 1 and 2. Type 1 is present in skin and other complex epithelium, whereas type 2 is present in intestinal epithelia. So this plectin and bullous pemphigoid antigen 1, as I mentioned already, they are high molecular weight proteins belonging to the plakin family. They have both N-terminal and C-terminal domains. So immediately beneath the basal layer, we have this basement membrane zone. The three layers I mentioned already is lamina lucida, lamina densa, also called as this basal lamina, and then the lamina fibroreticularis. So this is the basal keratinocyte, and these are the keratin filaments present in the basal keratinocyte, which is associated with this bullous pemphigoid antigen 1 and plectin of the hemidesmosomes. So if you see, this is the inner block of the hemidesmosome, and here this is the outer block of the hemidesmosome. Here you have the plasma membrane. So the inner block is attached with bullous pemphigoid antigen 1 and the plectin, and the outer block, as we saw already, it is IFAB300 and P200. Okay, now the lamina lucida. So this lamina lucida is the part that separates the plasma membrane from the lamina densa. So inside the lamina lucida, we have this anchoring fibrils. These are the anchoring fibrils which runs through the lamina lucida from plasma membrane to the lamina densa. So the proteins present in lamina lucida are, so we have this bullous pemphigoid antigen 2 or BP230, and then this alpha 6 beta 4 integrin, and then here a part of laminin 5. Also you have protein called unsin, which I mentioned already, and the mutation of unsin can lead to junctional epidermolysis bullosa. So below the lamina lucida, here you have the lamina densa. So this lamina densa, the major collagen present in lamina densa is type 4 collagen, and also it contains laminin 5. So even in lamina densa, you have this anchoring fibrils. So next is the sublamina densa or the lamina fibroreticularis. Here you have this anchoring fibrils. So these anchoring fibrils, they are curved structures, and either they terminate in the papillary dermis or they loop around and terminate in the lamina densa itself. That is, they loop around and again merge in the lamina densa itself. Here the main type of collagen is type 7 collagen. Okay. So this lamina lucida, it separates the plasma membrane from the basal lamina, and we have anchoring filaments which connect the hemidesmosome to the lamina densa by spanning through the lamina lucida. So the anchoring filaments, they are 3 to 4 nanometer, and as I mentioned already, the proteins present are bullous pemphigoid antigen 2, alpha 6 beta 4 integrin, a part of laminin 5, uncin, and the uncin mutation. We have this recessive junctional epidermolysis bullosa, and then laminin 1 and nidogen are intactin. So this lamina densa, you have this anchoring fibrils here also, which anchor lamina densa to the underlying dermis. So there are three types of elastic tissues here in lamina densa. They are oxytalin, eulanin and elastic fibers. So how do this oxytalin, eulanin and elastic fibers look like? So if you see, this is the dermoepidermal junction. So this oxytalin fibers, they will be perpendicular to the dermoepidermal junction. These are the oxytalin fibers. And this eulanin fibers, they will be attached to the oxytalin fibers. And this eulanin fibers, they are also attached to the elastic fibers that are present in the reticular dermis. So this is how it looks like. These are the oxytalin fibers, these are the eulanin fibers, and these are the elastic fibers in reticular dermis. So it contains laminin 5 and mainly type 4 collagen. So this lamina fibroreticularis, here also you have this anchoring fibrils as the main part. They are, as I mentioned, they are curved structures with irregular spacing, and they form loops around and merges with the lamina densa and contains mainly type 7 collagen. So if you see, it can either terminate in the papillary dermis or it loops around and merges with the lamina lucida. So the applied aspects are mainly autoimmune disorders, like autoimmune bullous disorders that can form due to abnormalities in the proteins in the basement membrane zone.